this is a great example of a partnership. We're talking about, you know, in the neighborhoods. You know, there's been a lot of criticism when I got here about the work that's being done in the Civic Center and downtown. But this is an effort that started in downtown very successfully, certainly an effort that was recognized proactively by the Homeland Department of Homeland Security. But now, effective today, we're launching the Lighthouse Project right here in the neighborhoods. Now, for me, this is personal. Personal because we really push out the importance of the neighborhoods and how partnerships count. But this gas station is a gas station that I personally worked at, pumped gas many years ago before becoming a Detroit police officer. So to start this effort here is meaningful to me. So I want to thank our partners. This is truly a public partnership, public-private partnership, Rock Ventures, Illich Holdings, and certainly Arab American Business Owners Association. You know, you've heard me talk a lot about clean stations, safe havens where our community can find a location to go. The Lighthouse Project in the neighborhoods at gas stations throughout the city of Detroit are those locations. You know, we talked about police stations being lighthouses in the neighborhoods that are now open 24 hours a day. This gas station and many others, part of this project, will be open 24 hours. Community can seek help, a safe haven, and I have a list of those, and then we're going to open up for questions and any of the other partners who want to answer any questions. Certainly this gas station located here at Wyoming and 6 Mile. Another location for a lighthouse, BP gas station at 17776 Grand River. BP gas station at 10601 East Outer Drive. BP gas station 10736 East Jefferson. Marathon gas station located at 8930 McNichols. Marathon 14700 East Jefferson. Mobile gas station 14820 East Jefferson. And lastly, the City of Detroit Airport, 11499 Connor Street. So again, this is truly a partnership. You know, standing with me is our neighborhood police officers, and certainly the neighborhood police officer for this specific area is Officer Bullock, who has had contact with the business owner here. And so we're excited. We're excited because this is only the beginning. I know that we'll have other lighthouses that will come through the city of Detroit, because these are the gas stations that community members will know, I want to go there and get my car serviced. I want to go there because it's a safe haven. This is a gas station recognized in partnership with the Detroit Police Department as a safe location. So with that, I ask if any of our partners from Illich, Rock Ventures, Arab Americans would like to say anything.
Hi, my name is Nasser Baydoun. I'm the proud owner of this gas station. And as a business owner in the city of Detroit, we're honored to be selected as a Lighthouse Project and to help develop this program. And we're also honored to be able to form a partnership with Chief Craig and the Detroit Police Department and Illich Rock Ventures, as well as Illich Holdings, our two biggest corporate partners. We saw how successful this program was in the downtown Midtown area, and we thought bringing it out to the neighborhoods to create a safe environment for people who are the citizens of the city of Detroit and those visiting Detroit. So look for the green light, and thank you very much.
Can you tell us how it works and how people know that this location is safe? I mean, what makes it safe? How can you be sure it's safe?
Well, it's not, you know, we can't guarantee. What the program does is offers people assistance. If they need assistance, they can come into the station. The employee will call the police if they have to. They're able to use the facilities, the bathrooms. You know the station because of the green light and the logos that are associated with it and all the other stations. And with the partnership with the Detroit Police, it allows them to respond faster and know that this is the good guys know that this is a place to come if you're in trouble, and the bad guys know that if you come here and cause problems, the police are going to respond quickly.
You know, and we want to get through some of the others who may want to say a few words. So, anyone from Illich or Rockford?
Nasser, please spell your name for us real quickly.
Nasser, N-A-S-S-E-R, Beydoun, B-E-Y-D-O-U-N. This is my only one. I own the city of Detroit.
Can we hold the questions till we get to that point?
Hi, Rick Fenton from Illich Holdings, and we're thrilled to see this expand to the neighborhoods. As the chief pointed out, this is all about establishing a safe haven for folks in the neighborhood to come. And once you start growing that, then you start growing other partnerships, and you spread the crime prevention theme, and you make a difference. And we've made a difference in the Central District. And this is going to be a great success in this neighborhood and other neighborhoods where this has been put. So, thank you very much. Thank you, Chief.
You know, thank you. Again, the key theme here is partnerships work. This is a neighborhood-focused effort. You know, there's a lot of discussion. It's not a community member that I don't meet that talks about, you know, liquor stores, gas stations. And here we are. This is a place that we want the community to come, and we're going to continue that partnership. So I guess we can open up for questions if you have any.
How about Brenda from DHS?
Oh, yes. How are you doing?
Thank you. Okay.
So, hi, Corinda Washington from the U.S. Department of Homeland Security headquarters in Washington, D.C. We have recognized the Lighthouse Project as a national best practice along with others around the country, and just an honor to be here on behalf of the department to salute Chief Craig and Rock Ventures and also Illich Holdings for setting such a precedence, and we look forward to assisting this partner, public-private partnership, and expanding throughout other communities around the city of Detroit. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Right. Thank you. Okay.
Chief, how long did this take from it to start as an idea to become a reality?
Well, you know what was interesting? We were having a regular meeting talking about the work in downtown, and I thought, you know, what if we replicated this into the neighborhood? You know, I made a commitment coming in some 8 months ago that we would be neighborhood focused, and such a great effort in downtown, why not put it in the neighborhood? So there's a lot of talk on what color the light would be, and I got to honestly say that it went from being a red light, and I said, we don't want a red light district. But I thought about my alma mater, I got to admit, Cass Tech, green light, and the sign, and if we could bring the sign up so you can...
There's one right in front of me.
It's one right here in front. Oh, okay. So the green and white sign, Michigan State, Cass Tech. But it's neighborhood focus, and the distinction is that the blue lights are in the downtown, midtown area. The green lights are in the neighborhoods. And this is a neighborhood-focused project, and that's why we have our neighborhood police officers here, and they're going to be working closely with businesses, and those businesses desiring to become part of the project, certainly we'll make an assessment. We'll work with the various businesses so that they can become lighthouses.
Chief, can you tell us why this works, how it works, what, you know, how does this work?
Well, it works because if, let's use an example. So it's no secret that we've had some violent crime, carjackings, robberies that have occurred at gas stations. And certainly, as Mr. Nassar pointed out, we can't guarantee prevention, but certainly when people see the green light, they know this is a place that they can have contact with a security person, they can make a phone call, they can get assistance. That's what works. As I've oftentimes said, you know, when you talk about closing police stations at 4 o'clock, that does not work. Our community needs to have access to police stations. They need to have access to good businesses like this 24 hours, 7 days a week. They will have security present, part of the build-in. This gas station in particular has cameras. It's clean. I've talked a lot about the cleanliness of a gas station because when it's dirty, it attracts other behaviors. This is a clean gas station. And so these are the places that our community, when they're leaving work 2 o'clock in the morning, they need fuel, they need assistance, they can come here or come to any of the lighthouses. We were selected based on the criteria of cleanliness, security, a willingness to participate, a willingness to partner with the Detroit Police Department. That was probably, and certainly the other partners could probably talk in more detail as to the selection criteria, because I know Mr. Nassar, he played a direct role on assisting on what locations would be selected.
How much do you plan to expand this?
You know, ideally, if we could have lighthouses every block, that would be wonderful. It's going to help us in our efforts to abate violence, but also dealing with quality of life issues. I've been very critical of locations, liquor stores and gas stations that attract loitering and other criminal behavior. So ideally, if we could have a lighthouse every block, that would be perfect.
If a business owner is interested, what do they do?
Well, they can contact certainly our neighborhood policing unit, Commander
Wilson.
Is he around? Commander Wilson, who represents the chief's neighborhood policing, certainly is a point of contact. And again, we are encouraging growth in this area. We want to see it grow.
And this is at no cost to the city.
No cost to the city.
So what is the role of the corporate sponsors?
They're funding LAMP. You want to talk about
it? Go ahead. Well, in concert with the Detroit Police Department, Mike and I developed the program initially for a central business district. And as the chief said, it was his idea to expand this out into the neighborhoods. So it was a unique opportunity for us to partner once again and try to develop something that could grow and expand to other businesses. So we're in gas stations today, and tomorrow it might be a new Meijer store, and it might be something else. And so it's a way to spur economic growth, but at the same time, spur places for the community to be able to shop and go where it's safe.
Where was this idea initially based?
Yes. Last year, the department held a public-private partnerships conference that we hold every year, and we were able to showcase three best practices across the country, one in the District of Columbia, another in Baltimore, the Baltimore City Watch program, and then now Lighthouse. And what it is a distinct public-private partnership. The U.S. Department of Homeland Security assists in that with helping to do memorandums of understanding and getting permissions to have access to the cameras, the footage that is on the cameras. But in Baltimore, and I will openly say this to Chief Craig, be able to facilitate a trip for DPD to go out to Baltimore to see what they're doing there. But they actually have the cameras on every block that are feeding into an emergency operations center with gunshot detection and things of that nature to help them reduce crime. Crime has dropped significantly in Baltimore because the amount of convictions and also judgments have been increased as well. So we want to be able to assist Detroit in being on that same fast track.
Are they all different names?
All different names. District of Columbia has not come up with a name, so we just say the District of Columbia Police Metropolitan Police Department's project. City Watch is the name of the program in Baltimore, and then Lighthouse. So, and there are other cities that are doing the same, and they have full license to come up with their own name.
Tigers game, you can get to this blue sign, you can call that number and they can help you, or you get your car broken into, someone can go. So I want to make clear what you all will be, the need you all will be providing for people in need, and what does the green light mean?
The green light means safety, safe haven. I mean, it's just that simple. There is a number, and I neglected to read it. There is a lighthouse number for the neighborhood light watch. Do we have that? I think it's on this side. There's a Project Lighthouse hotline number, 313-471-6490. 313-471-6490. And again, help will be provided to anyone who's lost, having vehicle issues, or any other non-emergency, not meant to replace 911. I just want to be clear, 911 is still a viable option. But certainly this gas station, those depicting the green light, are viewed as safe havens, just like our 12 precincts.
How old were you when you worked
here? I was 16 years old, so many years ago. I used to come here, my friend, I was always in the classic cars, and we'd come here and wax our cars and get ready for an evening. of cruising legally in the city of Detroit. And so so this gas station, I have a lot of memories here. And so, and to start and launch this neighborhood-based effort here is really powerful on many fronts. But I think the key is the public-private partnership. This is an effort that, you know, Illich and Rock wanted to bring out into the neighborhoods because they recognize that a safe Detroit is a safe Detroit in all of Detroit. And so, and that's what we're doing here.